going to understand Newton's laws. Before we start discussing Newton's laws, let me tell you something about Newton. Newton was born on Christmas Day in 1642. He was a very weak child, but he developed himself into one of the biggest geniuses that ever lived. When Newton was a student, he went to a book fair. All of you must have gone to some book fair or the other. There he saw a book on astrology. What is astrology? No, astrology is not the study of planets and stars. Astrology is a pseudoscience which claims that they can predict your future based not only on the position of planets and stars but on a number of other factors. So Newton saw this book called astrology and he bought that book just to find out what was there in it. He took it home and he started reading this book. As he started reading that book, he came across a diagram which he could not understand because he did not know trigonometry at that point of time. And these astrology books used a lot of trigonometry. So he went out and bought a book on trigonometry and started learning trigonometry. As he was learning trigonometry, again he got stuck because he did not know geometry. So he went out and bought a book on geometry and started learning geometry. So Newton learned geometry, then he learned trigonometry, and after that maybe he learned astrology, and 2 years later he invented differential and integral calculus. All of you have now learned geometry and trigonometry. We have to wait and see what you can do 2 years from now. But this is what Newton did 2 years after learning geometry and trigonometry. Newton was a big genius. When he was a student, there was an outbreak of plague in London. All the schools and colleges were closed. So Newton had to go back to his native village. Like we had swine flu holidays here for 2 weeks, Newton had 1 full year of holiday due to the outbreak of plague. And what Newton did in 2 years? He invented differential and integral calculus. He made some fundamental discoveries about the nature of light. And he laid the foundation of the law of gravitation. I don't know what you people did in your swine flu holidays, but this is what Newton did when he got a 1 year break. Newton was a big genius. There was a problem which scientists were not able to solve. This problem was called brachystrophon problem. Let us not worry what the problem is, but there was a meeting of scientists to find a solution to this problem. One scientist suggested that they should try to solve this problem in 6 months' time. Some other scientists said 6 months is too short a time to solve such a complicated problem. At least they should be given 1.5 years' time. So it was decided that the scientists will try to solve this problem in 1.5 years' time. This problem was delivered to Newton at 4 p.m. on one afternoon. Before Newton went out for work the next day, he invented a new branch of mathematics called calculus of variations and used that to solve the problem. So what other scientists thought they cannot solve in 1.5 years' time, Newton had solved in one night. So this was the genius of Newton. He has not only given us the laws of motion, he has made significant contributions to other fields. Before we start discussing Newton's laws, let's try to look at the situations where Newton's laws are not applicable. There are 2 situations where Newton's laws are not applicable. First, when the speed is an appreciable fraction of the speed of light. Einstein's special theory of relativity is applicable. We cannot apply Newton's laws in this case. Second case, when the size of objects is on the scale of atomic structure, then quantum mechanics is applicable. We cannot apply Newton's laws also in this case. In all other cases, we can apply Newton's laws. So now let us try to understand Newton's laws. First law. Earlier, people used to feel an object at rest will remain at rest unless it is acted upon by an external unbalanced force, and a moving body will come to rest unless it is acted upon by an external unbalanced force. This was based on daily experiences. Suppose we keep this duster at rest. It remains at rest unless some external unbalanced force acts on it. Suppose we move the duster, it automatically comes to rest after some time. So this gave a feeling that body at rest will remain at rest unless acted upon by external unbalanced force, and a moving body automatically comes to rest. This misconcept was corrected by Galileo, who said that a body at rest will remain at rest unless acted upon by an external unbalanced force, and a moving body will continue moving with uniform motion in a straight line unless it is acted upon by an external unbalanced force. So Galileo gave us the concept of inertia. And this concept was used by Newton to frame his first law of motion. So now let us state the first law. Every body continues in a state of rest or uniform motion in a straight line unless it is acted upon by an external unbalanced force. As per Newton's first law, a body at rest will remain at rest unless it is acted upon by an external unbalanced force. And a body moving with uniform motion in a straight line will continue doing so unless it is acted upon by an external unbalanced force. Now we see a moving body comes to rest. Now this is coming to rest because of frictional force. Now why do you believe that? Somebody may say the duster is coming to rest because of its own tendency. Now if we have a smooth surface and a rough surface, the duster will travel different distances. This clearly shows that the duster is coming to rest not because of its own tendency but because of something external. This is what is Newton's first law. Now let us try to understand the key points of Newton's first law. The first point is, Newton's first law is applicable to every body. Some textbook incorrectly state that Newton's first law is applicable only to inanimate objects. They feel that animate objects do not require an external force to accelerate forward. That is a totally wrong understanding. When I start from rest and start walking in the forward direction, I am able to walk forward and accelerate in the forward direction because of friction. If friction were not there, I wouldn't have been able to accelerate forward. Same way, all living things, all non-living things accelerate because of some external force. A car accelerates because of friction. A car decelerates also because of friction. A person is able to walk because of friction.